outgoing MPs of the 10th Parliament have been told to adjust their lifestyles if they are to manage life after Parliament. The August House has organized a two-day seminar to orient outgoing MPs on the opportunities and challenges that await them after their exit this May 2021. Take a look.
The question is it possible to have a life after Parliament?
We need to consciously prepare members of Parliament who exit Parliament. There are some who have stayed for two terms, others have stayed for three terms.
For the first time in history, Parliament has organized a session for outgoing MPs to orient them on life as ordinary citizens. Over 200 MPs who did not make it to the 11th Parliament after being voted out have only 2 weeks to exit the August House. The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, opened a two-day session today. She noted that life after Parliament is hard but possible.
That life after Parliament, of course, it's going to be different. You don't have a program like you have had here. You're not going to committee meeting. You're not going to the plenary. You're not going on a field trip as you have been. So we need to find ways of navigating this new life so that we are able to live comfortably. We have therefore brought a number of resource persons, many of whom have been here, so that they can speak to us and help us settle down in our new situation.
Several facilitators, who are mostly former MPs, preached hope. Sarah Chiinji, the former woman MP of Rakai District and former Minister of Internal Affairs, advised MPs to adjust to a new lifestyle that fits their pockets.
Don't feel embarrassed to change from the high life of a legislator, because you are no longer one. You can afford to move away from that one. It is okay for you to wear jeans instead of a suit, to get on a boda-boda if you need to. You can travel in a Noah instead of a Land Cruiser or any other thing. If you look at the situation, as Honorable Oldman has told us, you move from the village, move from a rented premise if you have some other place to go and you don't have a job in Kampala, it is okay.
She cautioned the MPs against rushing into litigations which suck them dry of money they would have invested after losing an election. MPs confessed that after election loss, lawyers approach them and entice them to challenge their defeat in courts of law, which lands them in huge debts.
Don't make hasty decisions, especially those that have far-reaching implications financially or emotionally. Don't go, to sell this, sell the other without really evaluating what it's all about. Don't go, there are people who think this husband or wife of mine did not support me. I saw her the other day with this and that person, so we are going for divorce. Don't go taking those kinds of decisions at this moment.
Emmanuel Sempala Chigozi, the outgoing MP for Makindye Sabagabo Municipality, said he went back to teaching after losing the elections and life couldn't be better.
I'm teaching economics and I've already been given assignments in the classroom, in senior five. I teach economics, I teach mathematics, and I teach computer science, and I'm already in class. I have no problem.
Have you been employed, or you are teaching your own class?
No, I'm teaching in the school that I started. Mm. I was a principal before I came. Mm. I relinquished the principalship. Mm. Now I'm back to principal and teaching.
So do you find any hardship in adjusting?
Definitely not. In fact, to the contrary, you can say I'm bigger than what I was when I was in Parliament. Mm. I'm much, much more comfortable now. Very comfortable.
The outgoing MPs who attended this session confessed that most of their fears have been allayed.
There was a lot of benefit in this session. First of all, they are members from the time actually they were declared that to have been defeated. They were lamenting a lot. Myself, I agreed on that very day, and it was okay up to date with me, but so many members have been lamenting. So I believe those who took in their time to come here and listen to what we've been taught here, they must have really understood that life has to continue and politics is not a permanent thing.
I need to accept that being in Parliament is over and I should be prepared to begin a new life. I should not think about the Parliament anymore, but I should think of fitting within the society where I'm going to be living once again, as before I became a member of parliament. What I was is that I need to go back and be the same person.
Me, this is very, very good. The presentations have been very informative. We listened from Mr. Ochichi, who is a practitioner in entrepreneurship, and has guided us what to do after here. I think there is a tendency to think that parliament is the end of life, but no, there are a lot of opportunities outside parliament.
The seminar was organized by the Institute of Parliamentary Studies, chaired by the Dokolo District Woman MP, Cecilia Ogwal. She recommended that parliament considers giving medical insurance to former MPs so they can have a smooth and decent transition.
The best way we can help members of parliament, not to make them look really desperate in the society, not to make them look out of place in the society when they have been leaders, is to make sure that we give them that pension. And in that pension, they should structure in. The parliament is not giving them any extra money, but that pension should be structured in medical scheme, because then that medical scheme will be taken together with that of parliament, so they will get what they call bulk discount, because the more number you are, the less the cost.
The Life After Parliament session continues tomorrow at Parliament. This story was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.
Meanwhile, the Ministry of Sports